Okay, let's talk about rounding. Rounding is something that I don't think a lot of people understand exactly kind of what's going on behind the scenes when we round. A lot of times teachers just tell you, well, look at the number to the right of it, and if it's five or higher, you round up, and if it's four or lower, it stays the same. But I'd like to show you what's really happening kind of behind the scenes of rounding. So let's take this example problem. We have 2,875 to the nearest thousand. Here's the way I want you to think about it. You owe me $2,875, and you show up and you say, "Hey, listen, I've only got $1,000 bills. Let's just pretend that these exist. I've only got $1,000 bills." And I say, "Oh, well, great. All right, well, then we are going to round it. So you're going to have to pay me to the nearest thousand." So basically, what we're asking or what we're looking at is if this is a number line, and here is 2,000, and here is $3,000, first of all, in the middle is going to be 2,500. Okay, and literally what I'm asking is which one is this $2,875 closest to? Is it closer to 2,000 or is it closer to 3,000? So the best way to do it, and you'll see on our class notes that I have you prove it using a number line. This is what I mean by that. So the best way to do it is to plot it, put your 2,000, your 3,000. We can also underline the place value, and that will help tell you what these numbers should be. Notice that I'm jumping one number here, so 2,000 to 3,000, or I'm jumping a whole 1,000. And I know that because it tells me the nearest 1,000. So I'm going to plug this in on my number line. So I know that 2,500 is here. Well, 2,800, let's see, this would be about 2,600, 2,700, 2,800, 2,900. So I know that 2,875 is going to be about right there. So again, now I'm asking myself, is it closer to 2,000 or 3,000? Well, we can clearly see it's closer to 3,000. So 2,875 rounded to the nearest thousand would be 3,000. Let's talk about that same number rounded to the nearest 10. Again, we're dealing with 2,875. So I'm going to underline the number that's in the tens place. So I know this is the ones place, that's the tens place. So when I draw my number line, because this is telling me to the nearest 10, I need to jump 10. So that means that this is going to be 2,870. This is going to be 2,880. And in the very middle is going to be 2,800. What's halfway between 70 and 80? 75. Oh, it just so happens that in this case, my number is exactly in the middle. So if you owe me $2,875 and you only have $10 bills, I'm going to tell you that I want $2,880 because since it's in the middle or on the right-hand side, it's closer to $2,880. So $2,875 rounded to the nearest 10 would be $2,880. Hope that helps.